Mike McKellar been able to come in and do in replacement of Ray Williams in your eyes?
Well, you know, Mike is a very smart football player, but, you know, I think he's just helped us maintain what we had on defense. You know, he's very smart. Mike is a leader. He knows how to get the guys going, and he knows how to line the guys up. So he's definitely added some consistency, or kept the consistency that we had there with Ray.
What does it do to a guy's growth playing next to him, and Craig Butler, a young guy in this league who can, you know, learn just osmosis?
Well, you know, one of those things about Mike, Mike's going to communicate. He's going to make sure that the guys, he's a true Mac linebacker for us, middle linebacker. He knows how to get the guys lined up. He knows how to command the huddle. He knows how to get the guys' attention. Same thing Ray did. Like I said, so like two peas in a pod there.
Terrell Mays may not have all the giant stats like some of his other teammates, but what does he mean to this secondary?
You know, teammates does an excellent job with his coverage ability, and he's a very steady factor for us. We'd always like to see him make more plays on the ball, and that's a part of his game that he's increasing with. But he's very steady, and he can play more than one position for us, and he can play it very well.
Was that move to the inside more so because of his talent, or was it more injuries? What was the...
A little bit of both. Like I said, you know, we're trying to find a home for him. We don't want to wear him thin, but he can play it. And as we go forward, you know, each week it kind of changes depending on what's the best matchups for us.
Do you have an update on Rod Williams?
Rod ended up getting a small fracture in his forearm, so he'll be out.
How long?
Probably about, I'm going to say, I can't give you the exact time. I know a little bit over 4 weeks.
Are you searching for somebody else to play that corner spot now?
No, we have guys in place. You know, Rod was just a healthy addition for us. He's a guy that, you know, we had on the radar in the offseason, and we had a chance to acquire him, and we did. And, you know, hopefully he's back for the playoffs. If not, we have a very good corner going into the next year.
How did he play last week, and how big of a blow is this?
He played pretty good. You know, he played steady, but at the same time, no offense to Rod, we've won games before Rod got here. You know, we just wanted to make sure we were strengthening ourselves in the secondary, and like I said, we were good enough, and we're doing some good things. It's a blow in terms of, you know, just we want to have some consistency back there, but, you know, Prince and those guys will line back up, and we'll be good.
Yet again, more changes to the secondary. How difficult has that been for those guys to find a rhythm with a different...
I think that is the rhythm. The rhythm has changed. One thing about myself and what I preach to the staff is we never want to stay the same. You can't stay the same because the game is ever changing. Each team is they're going to be different. So the guys understand that. You know, we change week to week with the systems and different things that we do just to make sure that our opponent doesn't get a beat on where we are.
What was the message after practice as you had the team gathered down here?
You know, there's always a day three message. And, you know, the biggest thing is just like, you know, hey, we're playing at home and we got to protect home. We have to do the little things right and, you know, all the things that helped us get out of that that adverse situation.
It was a different Mike Riley. It was a different Mike Riley last week than what we've normally seen. Do you expect him to go back to multiple reads, holding the ball a little longer and even running with it a lot more?
I think he'll run a lot more. I think he's going to do everything he can to try to, you know, get those wins and put that team on his back. As a young quarterback, he wants to show that he belongs in this league and that he can win some games. You know, so I think he'll play on the edge this week.
How do you react when a guy only gets one game with you before he gets injured? I mean, as a coach, what are your thoughts that way?
You know, like I said, I saw what I needed to see from him, so I know he'll be a positive factor when he does come back. You know, as a on a personal level, you hate to see any guy get hurt and lose that time. But I think, you know, our philosophy has been we have to move on to the next guy, not in a negative way, just because, you know, it keeps rolling.
With John Schick moving to the middle, it developed over time this season. What have you seen and why that move?
Well, one of the things is even before Alex came here, you know, I think Chick is a very aggressive type guy. He plays with a high motor on each and every play, and I think that'll give him – I think he's also a versatile player, and I don't know if he even knew that, but we wanted to see him on the inside and the outside. I think he has the ability to do both.
Was it because he went to the NFL he got a little more versatile? Or?
I can't tell you. I didn't have it before. I just know that, you know, when I look at him on film and when Richie and all of us sat down, I said he can do more than one thing, and we allow him to do it.
Are the Eskimos a wounded dog this week?
I don't know if they're a wounded dog, but, you know, it'd be good if they were a dog that stayed on the porch. That would help me. But at the end of the day, we got to play football.